The board that I'm about to review today got me genuinely excited. It looks similar to Nvidia Jetson Nano with a familiar form factor, has rather powerful CPU and a hardware for accelerating neural network inference. All for cheaper than the cheapest Nvidia Jetson board you can get. And if this wasn't enough, you can actually use that AI accelerator to run LLMs or large language models, which is not something you see every day or almost ever. But we'll come back to that very important point later. Now let's take a first look at Luckfox 3576. The board comes in a simple black box with a Fox logo on it and a minimum of accessories. There are multiple versions available with 4 or 8 GB of RAM, 0, 32, 64 GB of onboard MMC storage, and aluminum case or without. I got the 8GB version with no onboard MMC and the case. So when it came, it already was installed in the case. The case has an industrial device feel to it, especially since there are DIN rail mounts on top of the board and on the sides. And it feels really sturdy. The board has 2 USB Type-C interfaces, one for power and one for connecting the peripherals. One HDMI port, 4 USB Type-A ports, one of them is USB 3.0 and the rest 2.0, and 2 gigabit Ethernet ports, one of them supporting power over Ethernet or PoE. On the opposite side of the board, we can see a CAN bus header, power and ADC pins, and micro SD card slot, plus 2 antenna connectors. This is all you have access to without opening the case. To start working with the board, this is enough. But there is more inside, so let's open it up and have a look. You can notice that the board looks very much like Nvidia Jetson, same dimensions and very similar connector layouts. On the board, we see the SOM itself, which is called Core3576, a 40-pin GPIO header, 2 CSI interfaces for the cameras and 1 DSI for the display, an audio header, a few buttons, and a bunch of minor things like a microphone, RTC module connection, etc. etc. At the bottom of the board, there is M2 key M connector that can be used for attaching NVMe storage and Wi-Fi Bluetooth module with antenna connectors. In short, the board is absolutely packed with hardware interfaces. Let's leave it open for now and start it up. Support me in making more independent reviews like this one. Hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. The board is made by a Shenzhen-based company called Luckfox. It is a rather young company which I have heard about before, but never used their products until now. Why am I even talking about this? Because the quality of software support from Chinese companies can range from very decent to
you will be entirely on your own. Good luck.
In this case, it's somewhere in the middle. The documentation for Core3576 has all the necessary basics, but as you will be able to see, if you step off the beaten path, things become trickier. For the version without eMMC, you will have to flash the provided image to SD card. You have the choice of Android, Debian 12, and Buildroot. Debian here is the closest to what a lot of people used to when working with Raspberry Pi like SBCs, since Raspberry Pi OS is based on Debian. This is what we will choose. The first pitfall comes after downloading the image. The only way to flash it is using obscure Rockchip SD disk tool, only available for Windows. As a seasoned embedded engineer, I've got them all. I've got macOS, I've got Ubuntu 20.04, I got Windows 10. However, SD disk tool simply refused to see my SD card on Windows 10 machine. No amount of f**kery seemed to it. I had to install Windows 11 in VMware Fusion on Mac and flash the image there. Fortunately, That just worked. There are multiple ways to access the board. The easiest one for me is using SSH, which is protected by ultra-secure username-password combination. Rockchip provides a large library of readily available machine learning models to try out on the board with NPU acceleration. There are some really common ones like classification with mobile net and object detection with various YOLOs, some OCR post-detection models, and there are some more exotic and interesting ones, such as neural machine translation, speech-to-text with Whisper, and even text-to-speech. It's quite a bit more variety than your regular AI accelerator, which still tend to focus mostly on the vision models, as I discussed in my recent video. As a test, I wrote a Python script to run YOLO V10 inference with a web camera input, and it worked really well. The AI accelerator has 6 TOPS of integer 8 compute, which is 6 trillion integer operations per second. You can see benchmarks for each of the pre-trained models on the Model Zoo GitHub page. But accelerating vision models is old news. What really stands out here is rknn-llm framework, which can be used for speeding up the inference of LLMs, even pretty large ones. The name DeepSeek is in everybody's ears these days, and this is exactly what we're going to run on this board. There are a few demos in rknn-llm repository, including multimodal inference, so vision language models, Gradio web server, and a simple text-based inference. The most straightforward way to do a sanity check is to run text-based inference. In the documentation, they cross-compile the application on PC and then transfer it to Luckfox 3576. But if you have Debian 12 installed, there is no reason to do that because the executable itself is pretty small and you can just compile it on the board. Git clone the repository and do a shallow clone to save yourself some time. Change the path to the compiler and build linux.sh script and run that script. Easy peasy. Now download this exact model either from Google Drive or Lenovo Cloud and place it in the same folder as the executable you just compiled. Export the LD library path as specified in the README. And then simply run the executable. We now have a distilled version of DeepSeek running on this board. And it's super responsive too. So should you buy Luckfox 3576? If you need a powerful single board computer to run large language models or other types of neural networks, it does provide a lot of flexibility in types of tasks you can run, unlike, for example, Raspberry Pi AI hat. And all of this for a very competitive price. That comes with a few rough edges on the software side, especially if you want to do some customization. I will make at least one more deep dive video about the board. Subscribe and stay tuned for that. Meanwhile, watch one of my classic videos where I explain all of NVIDIA Jetson boards in less than 400 seconds.